lifting our hands to you. You we are, giving you thanks for all you do. And as we praise and worship your holy name, you are here, dwelling within our praise. For every answered prayer,
every answered prayer,
for always being there,
for always being there,
for love that hears us when we call, for arms that lift us when we fall. You have always been right beside us, leading us all along the way. We made it through because of you. Worship your holy name. You are here, dwelling within our praise. You are here, dwelling within our praise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, good morning to you all.
Good morning, Father.
We have gathered here to celebrate this Eucharist and to celebrate the death of our dear friend Lambert. Death is an event must be celebrated. No one can escape this event of death. It is not the end, that's what our faith teaches us. Jesus' death and the resurrection has given us a hope of eternal life. So every person's death is an event. It is not an end. Beginning of the new life and the one who believes in the resurrected Lord. Our friend Lambert believed in this resurrected Lord. And always, whenever it was possible for him, he took part in this holy sacrifice of Mass, which promised the eternal rest. Let us pray that God may grant him eternal bliss because of his faith. That is his faith that should achieve him this eternal rest. And as we have gathered here, let us ask the Lord the pardon for our sins. For many times we have failed, and we are failing to believe in the risen Lord. And to feel sorry for our sins, let us all together pray. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Lord God, have mercy on us.
Hear us pray. Incline your merciful ear to our prayers, O Lord, and grant to the soul of our servant, of your servant Lambert, the remission of all his sins, that he may have life on the day of resurrection and may rest in the splendor of eternal light. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
First reading, a reading from the book of Joshua. Choose this day whom you will serve. Joshua said to all the people, "Now therefore fear the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in faithfulness. Put away the gods which your fathers served beyond the river and in Egypt and serve the Lord. And if you be unwilling to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your fathers served in the region beyond the river or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." Then the people answered, "Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. For it is the Lord our God who brought us and our fathers up from the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage, and who did those great signs in our sight and preserved us in all the way that we went and among all the peoples through whom we passed. And the Lord drove out before us all the peoples, the Amorites who lived in the land. Therefore we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God." But Joshua said to the people, "You cannot serve the Lord, for he is a holy God. He is a jealous God. He will not forgive your transgressions or your sins. If you forsake the Lord and serve foreign gods, then he will turn and do you harm and consume you after having done you good." And the people said to Joshua, "Nay, but we will serve the Lord." Then Joshua said to the people, "You are witnesses against yourselves that you have chosen the Lord to serve him." And they said, "We are witnesses." He said, "Then put away the foreign gods which are among you and incline your heart to the Lord, the God of Israel." And the people said to Joshua, "The Lord our God we will serve, and his voice we will obey." So Joshua made a covenant with the people that day and made statutes and ordinances for them at Shechem. And Joshua wrote these words in the book of the law of God, and he took a great stone and set it up there under the oak in the sanctuary of the Lord. And Joshua said to all the people, "Behold, this stone shall be a witness against us, for it has heard all the words of the Lord which he spoke to us. Therefore it shall be a witness against you, lest you deal falsely with your God." So Joshua sent the people away, every man to his inheritance. After these things, Joshua the son of Nun, the servant of the Lord, died, being 110 years old. The psalm. Your response is, "O Lord, it is you who are my portion."
O Lord, it is you who are my portion.
Preserve me, God, I take refuge in you. I say to the Lord, "You are my God." O Lord, it is you who are my portion and my cup. It is you yourself who are my prize.
O Lord, it is you who are my portion.
I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, who even at night directs my heart. I keep the Lord ever in my sight. Since he is at my right hand, I shall stand firm.
O Lord, it is you who are my portion.
You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence. At your right hand, happiness forever.
O Lord, it is you who are my portion.
for he will come, come, ever come. Please stand for the acclamation.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory be to your Lord.
Some children were brought to Jesus that he might lay his hands on them and pray. The disciples rebuked the people, but Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and do not hinder them. For such belongs the kingdom of heaven." And he laid his hands on them and went away. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to your Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. My dear friends, in this gospel of today, we see Jesus wants his children to come to him so that he might lay his hands on them and pray for them. What is that Jesus liked in children? The attitude that is necessary to approach God was well manifested in little children. That's what Jesus liked. And when he says, "To such belongs the kingdom of heaven," he meant to say, the one who has childlike attitude will enter into the kingdom of heaven. And Jesus wants his disciples, everyone, whoever wants to enter into the kingdom of heaven, have this childlike attitude. My dear friends, we have come here to thank the Lord for the gift of Mr. our late friend Lambert. As I knew him, he had this childlike attitude in his life when it came to religion. In spite of being a well-informed man, in spite of his education, in spite of all the achievements in the world, he was like childlike attitude whenever he attended the Mass, religious person, deeply. And my dear friends, humility, simplicity, and genuineness I saw in him. I knew him for almost 7 years in Karanjale. I saw these qualities of a child in him, simplicity, simple man. Humble and genuine person. Let me share with you my experience, the dialogue, few times I had with him. Once I asked him, "Mr. Lambert, tell me, what is your take on Mopa Airport?" I asked him, I had gone to his house. He said, "Father, we cannot send away Navy. They protect us. They protect us. If another airport is coming, it is good for us. And what is there if someone else other than Goans also profit? They are also Indians. My dear friends, he was patriotic. He was a secular man. And he loved everyone. No religion, no caste, no creed. He loved every Indian. This statement of his, I remember till today. He said to me, Father, so I am from Parane. That's why I asked him, Father, let it come. If someone else also profits, helps, there are people. My dear friends, this was the love of this secular man for the society. And we know he loved India, he loved Goa, he was patriot. I had gone to him to write an article for my Christmas magazine that time when I was in Karanzalam before doing the construction. And I told him, Salamet, write something for my magazine, Christmas magazine. And the first question he asked me was, Father, what about the printing cost and all? How you manage it? I said, there are people, parishioners, helping me to meet the printing cost. Genuine question. He was the writer, and he knew the pains of the publisher in getting that material, the books printed. And his question for me was this, how you manage? Then he asked me that day only, he asked, Father, from where are you? First time I was meeting him, I said, I am from Mandre, Perne. He started laughing. He had a laugh. I said, Mr. Lambert, what makes you laugh? And he told me something. He said, during olden days, Portuguese time, he said, I had a priest, neighbor of mine from Kolwa. He was from Kolwa. And this neighbor of mine, this priest, was parish priest in Arambol. Mandre, Arambol. And he said, he used to come once in a way home to Kolwa. I was a young man, young boy. And he used to bring one laborer, Hindu, to work in his property. And he said, this Hindu used to tell me, in Konkani, Lambert said these words, Akavaran Ranangala. Akavarun Ranangala. Imagine what must have been Perne that time. That Hindu was telling him, he's put there in jungle. So he said, what I had impression was that Taluk Soglo Ranoti, no education, nothing. This was the impression I had. But further he said, Father, you have changed my impression. My dear friends, he said to me, Father, you have changed my impression. This is the, so far in my 26 years of priesthood, this is the biggest compliment, my dear friend, for me personally in my priestly life. I said he was a genuine person. Yes, he is a genuine. He was genuine enough to open to me. And he was genuine enough to accept the reality now. That's why I said he was a genuine person. My dear friends, our friend Lambert was truly patriotic, humble, simple, and genuine. He has taught us a lot. I am very happy, at least to thank the Lord for his gift. As a person known to me, I was connected to him after coming here to Karanzal. All of us must have experienced something good from him, some goodness. There is a lot you can learn from this man. Let us thank the Lord and celebrate this Mass and celebrate this event. I asked Dr. Jolly that time when he passed away, doctor informed me. I said, Doctor, Before I could tell her, doctor said, Father, I know you are on the move. No need to come. You can visit us later on. There is nothing, Father, to feel sad about. He outlived many. He had a good life, doctor said. Yes, my dear friend, he had a good life. Which is enough, I'm sure, for him to earn the eternal bliss. And the Lord, whom he believed, the real life and the resurrection, may grant him eternal life. Dear brethren, that your sacrifice and mine may be accepted to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Please rise. May the offering of this sacrifice be pleasing to you, O Lord, so that the soul of your servant, Lambert, finding through your mercy the pardon he sought for his sins, may exalt forever with your saints and praise your glory for all eternity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we have been redeemed by the death of your Son, shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
You are indeed holy, O Lord,
the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith.
Save us, Savior of the world,
of the
for
world.
By your cross and resurrection,
your cross and resurrection,
you have set us free.
Therefore, we celebrate the memory of his death and the resurrection. We offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that we are less worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francisco, our Pope, and Philip Neri, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Lambert, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all we have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, we have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us all together pray in the words our Savior Jesus Christ gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, with your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to take part in his banquet. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Deus, eu quero estar sempre contigo. Você é meu grande amigo e a você encontro paz. Por você eu sei que sou amado. Quando você está ao lado, a tristeza se desfaz. Deus, o teu abraço me conforta. Só você me abre a porta quando eu quero descansar. Com você eu fico mais seguro. Quando tudo está escuro, você vem para iluminar. Sou teu abrigo e verdadeiro. Você é meu companheiro. E você me faz tão bem. Sou a tua força absoluta. Faz parar a força bruta que eu mal possui também. Deus, eu nunca vou estar sozinho. Você é o meu caminho. E é você que me conduz. A escuridão se faz intensa e eu sinto a tua presença. Você é a minha luz. Quando foi do peito vai embora, você finge o que demora pra chamar minha atenção. Quando eu me descuido e sinto medo, só você sabe o segredo pra abrir meu coração. Deus, o teu amor é infinito. Sou viajante aflito e o teu amor me seduz. Tua paixão traz a felicidade. Você é a minha verdade. Os braços de Jesus.
Oh,
Let us pray. As we receive these heavenly gifts, we give you thanks, O Lord, and humbly pray that the soul of your servant Lambert, freed through your son's passion from the bonds of sin, may come happily into your presence. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
On behalf of our family, I thank Father Lawrence, the former parish priest of Our Lady of Rosary Church, a good friend to my parents. It was very heartening to listen to your interactions with Dad, and you described my father perfectly, Father. I also thank Father Cipriano, parish priest of St. Michael's Church, Taligaon, and Jennifer from the parish office for helping with the arrangements. My thanks to Father Rosario Oliveira, former parish priest of Our Lady of the Rosary Church, Carranzalen, who conducted Dad's funeral service. I thank Harlan and Clive for their invaluable help and for their constant supply of croquettes, which Dad loved. The lovely choir, you uplifted this service with your beautiful singing. Sylvia, Cherise, and Shanice, thank you. The beautiful rendition of Ave Maria was sung by my niece, Divya Mouse, who sent it to us from America. All our friends and neighbors at La Marvelle, who have been Dad's biggest fan club all these years, I thank you all. And of course, our go-to people for help and support. If we named everybody, we'd be sitting here for hours. So we will restrict ourselves to the few who we called on after Dad passed on. Uncle Nas, Shaila and Pranob, Dr. Fatima, Kaitan Philippe and Patricia, Peter, Dulari and Anastasia, Dr. Patricia, Norma and Everisht, Sandra and Oscar, our loyal Damiana and Jimmy, and our counselor, Yuvraj. Thank you for coming and joining this service today.
Please rise. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.